رجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
قل أعوذ برب الناس.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. So we had a discussion, a debate. We had Sam, Shimon, Hasumu, and David Hammer Time Wood, and what was the other guy? Anthony the Crook Rogers. So these guys came out, and I thought we had a good debate. And we at One Message Foundation are posting the entire debate in its entirety. We're not cutting out any part of it. From the beginning until the end, in two parts, we're posting the whole debate. We want honest Christians, Muslims, Jews, atheists, Hindus, and everybody else to see exactly what happened. We're putting the whole thing out there. We're not snipping anything out. We're not putting the whole thing out, right? What's interesting is these guys, they came with like tons of cameras and cameramen all over the place, but they're putting little clip bits out. They don't want to put the whole conversation. I wonder why. I wonder why they're ashamed to show what happened. But anyway, we're putting the whole thing out. So you can judge yourself which belief makes sense or doesn't belief make sense. And, you know, that's up to the people. When we have the Islamic Aqidah, we presented it. They have their belief, you know, 1 + 1 + 1 + soul and plus body and this and that. One, whoever you want to follow. What I found distasteful, and it's unfortunate because I thought we were having an honest conversation, is what they did. They made a little video on their way home. I guess it was a long, sad drive, like when you lose a soccer match and you're sitting together on the way back after losing a match. And they put this thing about Uthman got caught lying. Now, let's be honest. I mean, the issue was a hadith, and I want you guys to understand what happened. They claimed there was a hadith in a Tirmidhi. Jami' al-Tirmidhi is a book of hadith written by Abu al-Isa al-Tirmidhi that said that the Quran will come on the Day of Judgment in the form of a pale man and intercede for its reciter. Now, the hadith, I told them, and this was, again, I wasn't prepared for this. I was just there, and they brought this up. They had looked it up, whatever. I had not. They brought it up. But at that time, because I've taught hadith, and I have a master's degree in hadith, I knew that hadith is not in Tirmidhi. And I told them this is not authentic hadith, and this is not in a Tirmidhi. And you'll see them in the video on their phones. They're trying to find it. And they cannot, because it's not in a Tirmidhi. They were lying. This is a lie. Maybe they did it out of mistake. I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt. It was a mistake. But it's not in a Tirmidhi. They both said it is. Here, you can hear it.
That's in a Tirmidhi hadith. That's in a Tirmidhi hadith.
I know it's in Tirmidhi, but first.
Uthman asked us to show that to him. I simply mentioned that it's found in Tirmidhi, and he said, where? I found this kind of humorous because every time I hear Muslims cite hadith, they simply say it's in Bukhari, it's in Muslim, it's, you know, so forth. But he wanted us to give him the exact number and so forth. However, David was standing right there next to me, and he pulled up a version of the hadith that's found in Ibn Majah, and I actually hadn't even seen that one before. I was familiar with the one in Tirmidhi.
Now, both of them claimed it was in a Tirmidhi. I'm challenging them. I have a Tirmidhi here, they can get it. Find the hadith that you claim is in a Tirmidhi and it's not there. So you are not telling the truth. It's okay, I give them the benefit of the doubt, it's a mistake. But what happens is, then they claim that I was lying, or I got caught lying, because I told them that this hadith had da'af, it was weak. Now, this is where I really want their viewers to pay attention. This is their academic standard. They can't claim as if they have this knowledge. Sam thinks he knows Islam, and Anthony and David, they don't know. They're Google scholars. This is the extent of their knowledge, is Googling. That's what they were doing, Googling the hadith. They don't, so you see these books, this is what we study. I have a master's degree in hadith. So what they did, they Googled a random site, and when they found a site that said, they mentioned the hadith, even though they admitted that was in Ibn Majah, they were wrong about it being in a Tirmidhi. They were like, oh, it's Hassan, it's reliable, and you said it's Da'if. Not understanding the science. I have a mass, I do takhrij work here, right? I check hadith. Now that hadith that they mentioned from Ibn Majah, you see the video, he says from Ibn Majah. Here it is on your screen. The hadith is in fact Da'if. I know because I taught Aqidah and I taught this hadith. Now, the original book that you can find the hadith being graded as da'if in, weak in, is in Ibn Majah itself. This is a book called Da'if Ibn Majah, Sheikh Al-Albani.
Sheikh Al-Albani.
for the Christians who don't know, Sheikh Al-Albani was considered by the Salafis, primarily, the greatest 20th century hadith scholar.
Sheikh Al-Albani, he took all the weak hadith out of Ibn Majah, and that hadith is present here. And it's on your screen. If you see the bottom, it gives you the reference. It's hadith number 826 in Da'if Ibn Majah, and it shows the hadith to be weak. Now, the interesting thing is, they didn't have the book, they never showed a book, they never went and looked it up. Instead, they just Googled it and they're like, we caught you lying. And the sad thing is, it exposes their level of academics. These people are they're charlatans, they're fakes, they're cheating you. They're giving you this perception when all they're doing is Googling stuff. They're not researching, they're not looking it up. Now, why did that particular website grade it to be Hassan? Because there are other narrations, and I'm putting those in your screen now, that do mention from a stronger sanad that the Quran will intercede without mentioning coming in the form of a pale man. That narration from Ibn Majah is in it of itself weak. I had already put it on the screen. You can look up the actual narration, not just Google it, look up the book. Now, there are other narrations that do not mention it, the Quran coming like a pale man. Rather, it just says that for the one who recites the Quran, then the Quran and one of the narration, the Quran and the Siyam, the Quran and the fasting will intercede for them. What does that mean? It does not mean the Quran is a separate entity. This is their misunderstanding. Rather, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, as Ibn Taymiyyah has explained, said that the Quran here is thawab, yani the reward, thawabuhu, the reward of reciting the Quran. This good deed will intercede with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like fasting. Fasting is not a person. But the deed of fasting, like the hadith where sadaqah, when you give sadaqah, it will be a shade for you on the day of judgment. It doesn't mean that if you give a dollar in sadaqah, that dollar bill is going to come on top of you. No, the reward of sadaqah will shade you, will cover you on the day of judgment. Like that, the reward of staying up nights and reading the Quran, the thawabuhu, its reward will be an intercession. It will intercede with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran is kalamullah, the part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as-siyam and sadaqah, all these good deeds, the reward will be there. Now you see, they didn't know any of this. They didn't even know the grading of the hadith. They Googled it and then they made a false accusation that I got caught lying. When in reality, their ignorance is what got caught.
So we need to, I know this hadith, and that's why I was telling you, right? And I can show you the weakness in it if you like. Darussalam is a publishing house, not a scholar itself, right? Their grading by itself is not a hujjah, it's not an evidence. You have to look at the evidence from the scholars of hadith. Is that what I'm saying? That's why I asked you, right? Now, if you like, and if you, how long are you in San Diego?
Let me just finish.
How long are you in San Diego?
We're leaving tonight.
Okay. I was going to invite you to my house. I have a
man. I appreciate the fact that you would have invited me.
You got dinner, you got tea, I got you. Right? And I would sit with you and explain to you from the sharh of Ibn Majah why this hadith is da'if. Because I teach aqidah and I taught the subject.